There it is. 2.7.25. Let's see what it says here. After uploading, okay, blah, blah, blah. Added panorama, intelligent flight, landscape, portrait, wide angle, photo stitching, and sphere. Let's do it. Now, the last time I did a firmware update on this, I couldn't, it never would finish it. So I had to do it manually. It would never take it. I always get to 99% and crash. So we'll see, right? Alrighty. Yay. It did it. This time it worked. Let's go back and check. Okay, so. Okay, so there it goes. It's all done. Yay. Let's go check it out. Let's go fly. Alright guys, we're going to test this update, this 2.7.25. And I know they've updated the app a few times, probably since I even flown this thing. We're just going to see if it's okay. You know how it is with this stuff, right? Alright, you know how it goes. I always am hitting those buttons right there. It drives me crazy with this thing. Okay, well, let's start up the video and take off. How about we do that? There's a big hawk. I can see him up there. He's waiting around for the Evo. Okay, let's just take it for a little quick spin and okay, looks pretty good. Not acting up any. That's what we want. No acting up. Yeah, usually I only fly over here at 180 to 200, but I figured I'd crank it up a little higher this time. And yeah, they've got the shit built in already here. So 300, that's all you're getting. That's all they're gonna let you do. I mean, this is that was it Class E or something? I'm just not sure. There's the landfill. This landfill is pretty bizarre. How they there's like a rock quarry over here and the landfill at the same time. So they come over here and they bury the garbage and then they put the crushed rock over the garbage. It's giving you a view of Monroeville here. Yeah, so it's flying good. Evo 2. So they have put in those limits like DJI has, you know. There's that hawk up there. He's waiting. I don't know if he wants to mess with the Evo 2, to be honest. He's right there. He's circling, but he's not making any kind of power move or anything like that, so. Yeah. Okay, so it's, it's fine. Kind of check I want to do with the Skydio. I want to test the Skydio tomorrow whether or not if the range is better if you fly backwards. That's what I want to check with that thing. That was a droney, a crappy droney because I didn't have the camera tilted down enough, far enough. Let's see if I can get it. Okay, whatever. All right. So, yeah, it's flying good, man. I'm not seeing any problems with it. I mean, I mostly manually fly. I don't do a whole lot of the automatic flight mode stuff. Mostly I'm flying, you know, manually because I'm trying to, you know, do the stuff I want to do, you know, flying at those rivers and just to shoot the stuff I want to see, you know. It's hard to do that stuff in any automatic flight modes. You have to basically control the
thing yourself. Let me stop the video. Looks good. Yeah, it flew great, man. No problems, no, you know, toilet bowling or none of that crap. I didn't even do a compass calibration. Flew out there, no problem. Easy to see this bird. You can fly this thing pretty far line of sight. This thing's pretty easy to see compared to like a Mavic Pro or something. You can see this way better than a Mavic Pro. All right, guys, there you go. Yay. Have a nice day. Now I can get out of this sun. We fly over here at 180 to 200, but I figured I'd crank it up a little higher this time. And yeah, they've got the shit built in already here. So 300, that's all you're getting. That's all they're gonna let you do. I mean, this is that, Class E or something? I'm just not sure. There's the landfill. This landfill is pretty bizarre. How they, there's like a rock quarry over here and the landfill at the same time. So they come over here and they bury the garbage and then they put the crushed rock over the garbage. Just giving you a view of Monroeville here. Yeah, so it's flying good. Evo 2.